Hello guys, today I'm gonna build the AOS 5 from Chris Rosser. I think this is a very good frame and I want to try it out. My motors aren't in yet, but they will include in the video later on. And the frame, when you receive it, then you will receive it with these standoffs. But I get yellow motors, or gold should I say, and I want to have gold standoffs because I like that with yellow on this and make it a little bit nicer. So the frame, my stack choice is SpeedyB F7. I already formal coated it, so it's a little bit weatherproof, should I say. The cap with FatTech spike absorber, also formal coated XT60, and we're gonna build it with the DJI O3 air unit. Also have the antenna and the iflight GPS on there. And I have a crossfire module, so let's start building. I think follow the recommended steps of Chris, and he says that put your EC and stack around and put the leads on here. I want to leave the XT60 longer, because then I have more room and angle for the GoPro that we're gonna fit on here. But still, then you have the XT60 on top, that's no problem at all. So around the side maybe, and then, so I need to figure it out. There are some screws that are coming with the frame, and that are these screws. Don't drop them. And we have this little nut that will fit over, and I want to use that as a spacer, so I'm gonna try to show you. Also, I think it's maybe wise to route this unit cable under here. Okay, we have now some nice airflow underneath and no blocking. Ensure if the screws are tight enough. Okay. So off camera I did put the cable under it, and I put the connectors on it. So we're gonna close it now. So that's in. We have a nice airflow underneath for a hopefully cooler air unit, because they are known to overheat. I want it under like this. But here it is, and I hope it will fit properly. Still hot. Okay guys, I did some things off camera, mounting the stack, as you see, mounting the plug and soldering on the capacitor with the spike absorber. And my motors came in. Some nice stickers. These are the 22.6.5 with 2020 KV. So we're gonna mount those. Feels strange that the overhang of the motor mount is there. Feels strange. Never had that, but should be good. Okay, looks good. Oh yeah, the frame does also come with those. Will I use them or not? I don't know. Okay, tell me in the comments if you prefer covers for the wires, or do you prefer taping or zip tying? Let me know in the comments. It looks cool. That's new. Normally I run the wires like that, straight away from here and then to there, but I want to do it differently this build, so.
I lost the footage, soldering on the crossfire unit and mounting it. So that's, I don't know where the footage went.
Hey guys, I finished the build and already did some test flights and tuned it as well. You see a lot of grass from testing. I like the frame a lot. because this frame is so sturdy, I didn't need to tune a lot or tweak a lot in Betaflight. It's running Betaflight 4.4, and I only need to GPS install or configure. For the rest, it's flying pretty darn good. What can I tell about the frame? No, the frame is amazing. Low resonance, no. I didn't see anything strange. Also, like this kind of high kV motor from RC In Power. And yeah, it was the first time flying with the O3 air unit, so I love that view in the goggle. That's also amazing. This is my GoPro 10. Here you see me doing flips and rolls for the tuning of the quad, and after that the first flight with the drone. I hope you liked this video, and if you have any questions, leave them down below, and I will see you next time. Bye!